Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video we will discuss about loan prepayment, and mainly we'll discuss about one myth, a very common typical myth and a very common typical fact. So if you have any kind of loan, home loan or car loan or personal loan, then stay tuned. This video is going to be very useful to you. Let's continue. So before we understand the myth, let's see this graph quickly. See, this is a very typical loan payment graph, and there is no extra prepayment in this graph, just the simple EMI. So this top part is the interest and the bottom part is the principal. So typically what happens in initial few years, you will see more interest, okay, which declines with time, and in the initial year you will see less of the principal, which increases with time. Okay, now seeing this graph, so the myth is people believe that in the later years, because anyhow they are paying only the principal and there is hardly any interest, so they believe that prepayment doesn't make sense. So this is actually a myth, it's not a correct understanding, this is a wrong understanding. So we'll understand that with a demo. So for the demo purpose, we will take the most typical case, the home loan. So we are taking 30 lakhs as the loan amount, interest rate 9%, which is the current interest rate in the market, and the typical tenure 20 years. So with this data, we will see how that understanding is incorrect. Okay, so let's start the demo. So for the demo purpose, I'm using one EMI calculator. You can use any EMI calculator. Okay, so this is the data. Loan amount is 30 lakhs, interest rate is 9%, and the tenure is 20 year. Okay, now let's see the year wise data. So you can see the year wise table, 2019 how much we are paying, 20 how much we are paying. Okay, and so this is the principal column. See, in the initial year we are paying less principal, 56,000, 61,000, but this principal increases with time. So this is 1 lakh plus, this is 2 lakh plus in 2034. Okay, and this is the interest amount. So you can see initially we are paying more interest, 2 lakh plus. Okay, and this interest decreases with time. So here you can see it is less than 2 lakh, 1,97,000. So here you can see it is less than 1 lakh in 2035. Okay, and this is the balance amount. So after paying this much of principal, how much is the remaining loan amount? Okay, and this also obviously decreases with time, and finally it goes to the zero, and then our loan ends. Now let us understand about the myth, the misunderstanding. Okay, now the question here is, are we paying any less interest in the last few years? So the answer is no, we are not paying any less interest. See, the interest which you are paying, let's say in 2033, the interest which you are paying is based on the principal amount remaining. Because the principal amount has reduced, you are paying less interest. It is not because of the later year in the whole tenure or the beginning year. Okay, now for the understanding purpose, let us assume you are taking a fresh loan of this amount. Then what will happen? Let's see. So you can see we are taking a fresh loan of 14,97,000. Okay, interest rate is same, tenure is 6 year. Why 6 year? So we are taking from 2033, when this is the due amount, the loan amount. So how many year we want to pay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 year. Okay, so if you want to pay for 6 year, then let's see the calculation. So here you will see exact same calculation even for the fresh loan. So in the first year you will pay 1,26,000 as a interest, next year 1,08,000, next year 88,000. Here also exactly same, 1,26,000, 1,08,000, 88,000. Okay, so my point is, bank doesn't take a single rupee extra in the beginning year or in the later year. They will take exactly the required interest based on the principal amount due. Okay, see, in the beginning year, when the principal amount, the loan amount was very high, we were paying high interest. Okay, but now in the later year, because the principal amount has reduced, the loan amount has reduced, we are paying accordingly less interest. That's it, that's the only thing. And why the principal is increasing? Because we have kept the EMI constant. See, for the smaller loan amount you are paying high EMI. The EMI which you are paying for this much loan is also same for this small loan. So because the loan amount is lesser and you are keeping the EMI constant, the interest is lesser, the more amount will go into principal. Okay, so that's why the principal is increasing. It's not because in the later year or in the beginning year, it's all about the principal amount due. So even if you do the prepayment and if you reduce this principal further, then your interest will reduce even further. So prepayment always makes sense if you have the spare money at any given point in time in the whole loan tenure. Okay, let's continue. Okay, now let us understand one fact. See, this fact is applicable only to the home loan. So the fact is, people save tax on the home loan. So this understanding is correct, but there are a few conditions which we will see. For the understanding and the validation of this fact, we will see one demo. So for the demo purpose, we are taking these figures. Let's say the loan amount is 22,50,000. Okay, interest rate is 9%, tenure is 20 years. Okay, now let's see the calculation. Okay, so here we have two calculation. One is without prepayment, one is with prepayment. Okay, and we will see which one is beneficial. So in this case, the prepayment is zero. We are not doing any prepayment. Here, let's assume you did the full prepayment. So there is no loan anymore. Here you will pay interest somewhere close to 2 lakh rupees. Okay, if you calculate the interest with this loan amount and 9% interest rate, then you will pay close to 2 lakh rupees as an interest to the bank. So this is loss, that's why it is minus. Okay, here because there is no loan, you will not pay any interest to the bank. Okay, in this case you can save the tax. If you are in the higher income tax bracket, then you can save up to 60k. okay, so the maximum tax exemption limit on the home loan interest is 2 lakh rupees. So 30% of 2 lakh is 60k. You can save up to 60k. This is saving, so this is plus. Okay, in this case, because you don't have any loan, so you cannot save the income tax. Okay, here the FD interest is zero. In this case, you have paid this much amount to the bank to clear your loan. Otherwise, this amount you could keep in the FD. So in India, in 2019, the latest interest rate is 7% on the FD. So 7% of this amount is close to 1.6 lakhs. Okay, in this case, you are losing this amount. Okay, because you did the prepayment. So now let us see the total loss. Okay, here you paid 2 lakh rupees as an interest, but you saved 60,000 on the income tax. So 2 lakh minus 60k is 1.4 lakhs is the total loss. But in this case, you lost the FD interest 1.6 lakh. Okay, plus you also did not save the income tax. So the total loss is 2.2 lakhs. Okay, so if you compare these total loss, obviously this is bigger loss. If you are doing the prepayment, then it's a bigger loss. But you have to understand that this calculation is based on these figures. When your loan amount is this much, 22,50,000. But let's say if your loan amount is very high, let's say 50 lakhs, then the interest that you pay is very high and the tax exempted is only 2 lakhs. So this is the only amount which is tax exempted. So if you are paying any interest above this amount, you cannot save tax on that. This is the maximum tax you can save. Okay, so that is one thing to be noted. If the loan amount is very high, then prepayment makes sense. Okay, and the second thing is, if you are not in the 30% slab, say if you are only in the 10% slab, then you cannot save up to 60k. You can save only up to 20k. So these are the variable parameters, the loan amount and the tax bracket. Based on that, you need to calculate and take a good call. Okay, so that's it guys, that's all for this video. If you like this content, please hit the like button. Do subscribe my channel for more videos. Share this video with your friends and family. Thanks for watching.